Hi guys, welcome back. We shall now be talking about ARDS, that is acute respiratory distress syndrome. So let us now study that why in this condition do you have what is called as a non-cardiogenic pulmonary edema. Let's knock some sense into these terms like cardiogenic and non-cardiogenic pulmonary edema. And what I'm first trying to represent before you is what is called as cardiogenic pulmonary edema, which could be occurring due to conditions like mitral stenosis or cardiomyopathy or myocardial infarction. In this diagram, I have shown that unfortunately, the person is having a sudden onset left ventricular failure. So you can see that the pressure in the left atria will also begin to rise because the blood after all has to go from the atria to the ventricles. And if the pressure of the ventricles will rise due to failure, then left atrial hypertension will occur. Because of this left atrial hypertension, there would be congestion in the pulmonary circuit. And therefore, the patient will be having what I can say simply as cardiogenic pulmonary edema. One of the highlights of cardiogenic pulmonary edema is that the patient would be having a presence of left atrial hypertension. The basic pressure in the left atria would be increased primarily because there's a backflow that is occurring in this patient. By backflow, I do not mean the fact that there is an actual transportation of blood because there is no regurgitation, but the pressure situation will change in the heart secondary to LVF in a patient due to any etiology. Therefore, cardiogenic pulmonary edema, the characteristic feature is that there is an increased pressure in the left atria. But if imagine a person is having swine flu or bird flu and he did not get proper treatment, the swine flu virus will not say anything to the heart. It will directly damage the lungs, and the direct damage to lungs will result in development of what is called as non-cardiogenic pulmonary edema. So what is so great about swine flu and bird flu that they are contributing to pulmonary edema? Well, swine flu virus will damage the pneumocytes. One of the important cells that are damaged in ARDS, which occurs secondary to swine flu or bird flu, is damage to the pneumocytes, which constitute a chunk of the surface area of the alveoli. If the alveoli will collapse, there would be hypoxia, and hypoxia in turn will damage the endothelial cells. The endothelial cells will become leaky. Therefore, when we study the pathogenesis of non-cardiogenic pulmonary edema of ARDS, we always study regarding leakage of fluid from the pulmonary capillaries into the alveoli of the patient. This circle here represents the alveoli, then is the surrounding blood vessels. And you can see that these blood vessels have become leaky. There is leakage of fluid, which normally does not happen in you and me. See, if a person is having a cardiogenic pulmonary edema, then there is increase in hydrostatic pressure in the blood vessel. That will cause transudation of fluid. But here I'm not saying that there is any transudation of fluid due to increase of hydrostatic pressure in the blood vessel. The pressure in this blood vessel of the blood vessel which is surrounding the alveoli is perfectly normal. But still, because of damage to the gap junctions which are present between the cells, because of the integrity of the endothelial cells getting impacted, there is a pulmonary edema developing in a patient. I would like to call this non-cardiogenic pulmonary edema. So the highlight of ARDS is that it is an example of a non-cardiogenic pulmonary edema. This condition will be occurring in approximately 10% of total ICU patients. So before we go into the technical definition of acute respiratory distress syndrome, as a broad perspective, I would like you to remember that if a person is having sudden onset respiratory distress due to various triggers that I'll be explaining to you, the triggers can range from swine flu pneumonia to toxic gas inhalation to aspiration of stomach acid. But if a person is having a sudden onset respiratory distress with chest x-ray finding of bilateral infiltrates, which cannot be explained from the cardiogenic perspective, in a sense that person is not having any bat wing edema, there is a presence of demonstrable hypoxia in the patient, and a person is having normal left atrial pressure. Mark my words there. When I started this topic, I taught you that if a person is having cardiogenic pulmonary edema, there will always be increased pressure in the left atria. But in acute respiratory distress syndrome, which could occur due to conditions ranging from swine flu, bird flu, Mendelsohn syndrome, and many others that I will enumerate before you from MCQ perspective, if you read regarding chest x-ray having bilateral infiltrates, which might look like that of a cardiogenic pulmonary edema, might look like, not exactly cardiogenic pulmonary edema, might look like cardiogenic pulmonary edema, there's a demonstrable hypoxia, but the pressure of the left atria is normal, then we say it is ARDS in a patient. Please appreciate the fact that in ARDS, the damage is directly in the lungs, the heart is not involved. That is why the keyword that is most important for you to relate as a doctor is non-cardiogenic pulmonary edema is a highlight of this particular disease.